हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर LFCS ऑनलाइन क्लास। माय सेल्फ संध्या तिवारी, योर SST टीचर। एज यू ऑल नो दैट योर सेकंड सेमेस्टर एग्जामिनेशन इज ओवर एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर थर्ड सेमेस्टर सिलेबस। सो इन योर SST वी हैव थ्री पार्ट्स। इन फर्स्ट पार्ट इन हिस्ट्री इन दिस टर्म वी हैव टू स्टडी three chapters, that is first chapter is Harshvardhan and his time, and second one the Chalukyas and the Palvas, and the third one that is culture and science. Okay, now comes to geography portion. You have to study only one chapter, okay, that is India, natural vegetation and wildlife. And now come towards civics portion. In this portion also, in civics also, you have to study only one chapter, that is chapter 30, making a living, rural livelihoods and urban livelihoods. Okay, so let's first of all, in this semester we will start history portion, chapter 13. Okay, see here, SST history chapter 13. In this chapter we will discuss about Harsha, which chapter? Harshvardhan and his time. In this chapter we will discuss about political development and also new empires and kingdoms. Okay, new empire means Samraj and Rajya. And first of all, first topics in this chapter, that is Harsha's accession, and second one that is Harsha's conquest. And after this topic we will discuss about Harsha's patron of Buddhism, and the other topic that is Harsha a great scholar and patron of learning. And next topic that is Huang Sang and his account. And in this first topic is Harsha's administration, and also we will discuss about society and life of people, and also about Harsha's assemblies, and last that is Nalanda University. Okay, these are the topics we have to study in this chapter. Okay. First two topics we will discuss today. First one that is Harsha's accession. Harsha's accession. Okay, and second one Harsha's conquest. In this Harsha ascended the throne in 606 AD when he was hardly 16 years of age. Okay, and second Harsha's conquest. After strengthening all his power and position, Harsha's first task was to defeat Sasang, the ruler of Bengal, or the king of Bengal, and to take revenge for the deaths of his brother and also his brother-in-law. Okay beta, so let's start our today's class chapter in history, chapter 13, that is Harshvardhana and his time. Okay, so open your book, page number 89. Okay. Political development, new empires and kingdoms. Okay, samraj aur raj ke bare mein hum padhenge. Okay, so let's start. After the fall of the Gupta Empire, chaos and disorder prevailed everywhere. It is said here that after the downfall of Gupta Empire, everywhere, it means here and there, everywhere, what prevailed? Means sare jagahon par uthal puthal mach gayi aur sari cheeze kya ho gayi? Disorder mein ho gayi. Okay, after the डाउनफॉल ऑफ व्हाट? फॉल ऑफ गुप्ता एम्पायर. सारे जगहों में उथल पुथल मच गई. द हूना इन्वेशंस, created more confusion, and after the Hunas invasion attack, there created a lot of confusion. What type of confusion? It all lead to the emergence of small kingdoms. After that, there created many small kingdoms. Come out small kingdoms means उसके बाद से कई सारे छोटे छोटे राज्य उत्पन्न होकर के सामने आने लगे. ठीक. थानेश्वर नियर कुरुक्षेत्र वाज वन ऑफ देम. उन सब स्टेट्स में से किंगडम में से एक ऐसा था जो कि क्या नाम था, कुरुक्षेत्र. थानेश्वर जो कि कहां पर था, कुरुक्षेत्र. इट मेड ग्रेट प्रोग्रेस अंडर प्रभाकर वर्धना एंड हिज सन हर्षा. और यह राज्य, यह किंगडम उनके समय काल में बहुत ही प्रगति पर था, यानी प्रोग्रेस पर था. किसके समय काल पर? प्रभाकर वर्धना एंड हिज सन हर्षा. किसके टाइम में बेटा? प्रभाकर वर्धना एंड हिज सन हर्षा. ओके. हर्षवर्धन इज रिगार्डेड एज द लास्ट ग्रेट रूलर ऑफ एंशियंट इंडिया. And also one more important thing you have to write down in your copy, that the last and also Harshvardhan also one of the last great ruler of our ancient India. Okay, underline this. Got it, beta? Now next topic, that is second topic. First, now we will start. We just studied about introduction, and now we are going to start our first topic, that is Harsha's accession. Harsha ascended the throne in 606 AD when he was hardly 16 years of age. Harsha ne rajgaddi par unka abhishek, unka tilak kab hua? Bahut choti si umr mein. When he was hardly 16 years of age. 16 साल की उम्र में ही उन्होंने राजगद्दी पर बैठा, प्लस उनका अभिषेक हुआ, राज तिलक हुआ. ओके, गॉट इट बेटा? यस. इट वाज द टाइम व्हेन द रूलर्स ऑफ गौर, एंड इट वाज आल्सो अ ग्रेट एंड आल्सो वेरी हार्ड टाइम फॉर हिम, एंड आल्सो इट वाज द टाइम व्हेन द रूलर्स ऑफ गौर, दैट इज और बंगाल and Pallavi or Gujarat had treacherously murdered his brother-in-law. बड़े ही विश्वासघाती तौर पर उन्होंने उनके brother-in-law की हत्या कर दी, यानी murder कर दी. Okay? Grihavarman, क्या नाम था? Grihavarman, the ruler of Kannauj. He was the ruler of Kannauj. Who was the ruler of Kannauj that time? Grihavarman was the ruler of Kannauj. And then his elder brother Rajyavardhana, and after killing his brother-in-law, he moved towards and also he killed his brother Rajyavardhana. So when Harsha ascended the throne, his kingdom was being threatened by his ancestral enemies. और ये उस समय की बात है जब हर्षा राजगद्दी पर बैठे और उन्होंने राज्यभार संभाला, तब क्या हुआ? उसके बाद से his kingdom was being threatened by, और उनके राज्य को उनके दुश्मनों के द्वारा धमकी दिए जाने लगी. The rulers of on who gives threat to Harsha, mostly ruler of Gujarat and Bengal. Okay, the rulers of Gujarat and Bengal. The first task that Harsha accomplished after his accession to the throne of Thaneshwar was to march towards Kannauj. After rajgaddi par baithne ke baad unka first task tha, first maqsad tha, अपने बहनोई और भाई के मृत्यु का बदला लेना था. ठीक. फर्स्ट अकम्प्लिश्ड क्या काम पूरा करना था, accomplished means पूरा करना, to complete. After the throne of Thaneshwar was to march towards, किसकी तरफ बढ़ना था, march towards Kannauj की तरफ बढ़ना था. Where first of all he saved his sister Rajshri. वहाँ पर जा करके पहले वो अपनी sister को राजश्री को बचाना चाहते थे. He wants to save his sister Rajshri. And then united the two kingdoms of Thaneshwar and Kannauj. And after saving his sister, he tried to combine and also unite the both kingdom, that is Kannauj and Thaneshwar. Okay? And after combining both the kingdom, thereafter he made Kannauj his capital. After combining both the kingdom, he lastly made Kannauj as his capital. Okay? Got it, beta? Is it clear? Yes. Now, second topic, that is Harsha's conquest. Conquest means vijay. Harsha, ab hum Harsh ki vijay ke baare mein padhte hain. Okay? After strengthening his position, अपने position, power की बढ़ोतरी के बाद, वृद्धि के बाद क्या हुआ? Harsha's first task was to defeat Shashank. उनका पहला task था, पहला काम था Shashank को हराना. The king of Bengal. Who was Shashank? Shashank was the ruler of or king of Bengal. And to take revenge for the deaths of his brother and brother-in-law. Shashank के ऊपर आक्रमण करके उनको मारना, ताकि मारने के बाद वो अपनी अपने भाई और अपने brother-in-law के death का बदला ले सके. Revenge means बदला. Okay, got it, beta? Yes. According to Huang Shang, a Chinese pilgrim, according to one of the most important, and also you can call him one of the most important traveler, that is Huang Shang, a Chinese pilgrim. Harsha spent 6 years of his reign time, 606 to 612 AD, in conquering the five Indies. He spent, according to Huang Shang, Harsha spent almost 6 years of his life only in conquering which five Indies? Which are these? That is Eastern Punjab, Kannauj, Bengal, Bihar and Orissa, and many other states. Not only these, he also conquered many other states. Okay? After consolidating his empire in the north, after giving more power his in north, अपने consolidating means क्या होता है, मजबूत करने, अपने power को और अपने empire को उन्होंने north में मजबूत किया. He turned towards, and after that, after strengthening his power towards north, he moved towards Deccan. Towards Deccan, but his advance was checked by, but suddenly, or you can say by mischance, his advance was checked by whom? Pulaski second. Unki advancement ko kiske dwara रोका गया, कौन रोक दिया? पुलस्किन सेकंड ऑफ द चालुक्या डायनेस्टी. चालुक्या डायनेस्टी के पुलस्किन सेकंड ने उनका आगे बढ़ना रोक दिया. ही वाज द किंग ऑफ बादामी और वातापी. चालुक्या पुलस्किन सेकंड कौन था? ही वाज द किंग ऑफ बादामी और वातापी. ओके, thus Narmada became the southern limit of his empire. इस तरह से उनका जो नर्मदा तट पर, वो सबसे southern limit था उनके empire का. And which included, जिसके अंतर्गत क्या आता है? Eastern Punjab, the whole of, you can see map also given here, 13.2, empire of Harsha. I will show you later on through map of Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Bengal, Orissa, and parts of Sindh and Kashmir. And also you can see through with the help of map, see here, which states, see here, whole of Uttar Pradesh, you can see here Uttar Pradesh, and also you can see Bihar also, and after Bihar, you move towards Bengal, West Bengal, and also move towards Odisha, okay? And also some portion of Sindh. Sindh, this portion. Okay, beta? See? Yes. Okay, got it? And also, you may not forget Kashmir. This area also. Kashmir, Sindh, Jammu and Kashmir. No, only Kashmir. Okay? So, today only this much. Next video we will discuss about next topic, that is Harsha, a patron of Buddhism. Okay, so today only this much. Thank you.